Welcome to the Fit Small Business Xero training course. In this lesson, we're going to cover how to set up products and services in Xero. To follow along with me, log into your Xero account now or click the link below this video for a free 30-day trial of Xero. You can also click this link to access our full Xero course and other helpful resources. Let's get started. One of the benefits of using an accounting software program like Xero is the amount of time it will save you when it comes to managing your day-to-day business operations. Unless the products that you sell are custom-made for each customer, you will generally have a list of core products and services that you sell to your customers. By taking the time to set up your products and services in Xero, you will be able to create invoices, purchase orders, and other forms in a few short minutes. Instead of having to type out each product or service on the form, you will be able to make your selections from a drop-down list. For the purposes of this lesson, we will discuss how to enter inventory items individually into Xero. However, if you are converting from another accounting software program and you have a lot of items, you can import them into Xero from a CSV or Excel file. Head over to our How to Import Products and Services lesson for step-by-step instructions on how to do this. You can access this lesson by clicking this link. There are two ways to set up inventory in Xero. First off, if you sell products or services that you do not need to keep track of the quantity and cost for, those items will be set up as untracked inventory. For example, any kind of service such as consulting or bookkeeping services would be considered untracked inventory. On the other hand, products that you need to keep track of the cost and quantity purchased and sold will need to be set up as tracked inventory. For example, if you purchase cases of water that you turn around and resell to your customers, then you should keep track of what you paid for the water as well as how much you sell the water for. This will allow you to run reports so that you can gain a better understanding of your sales and profit margin. Whether setting up untracked inventory or tracked inventory items, the steps are exactly the same. Let's walk through the steps to add a new inventory item to Xero. From the Accounts menu, we want to go ahead and select inventory. So this is the list of our inventory items that we have currently set up in Xero. So we'll go ahead and click the New Item button here. Let's walk through each of these fields so that you can see what information you need to provide in order to set up a new item. We'll go ahead and set up a Build Website item for Acme Web Pros Plus. The item code field is a unique code up to 30 characters long that should be assigned to the item so that you can easily identify it. For example, if your items have an SKU, an ISBN number, or a UPC code, use this number as your item code. For services, you could use a shorter version of the item name as we are doing in this example. So our item code is website, and then the item name will be build website. The item name is a description that tells you exactly what the item is that should be included here. This field can be up to 50 characters long. By marking the I track this item field, you want to track the quantity and cost for anything that you select here. So once you select it, the account field will display to the right. And this will show the account that will be used to track the item for accounting purposes. And for this example, the account is inventory. If you are setting up a service or product that you do not need to keep track quantity and cost for, then there is no need to put a check mark in this field. One thing that you should note is once you have posted transactions to an inventory item that you are tracking, you can no longer make any changes or revisions to the actual account field, this field here. I purchased this item. If the item that you are setting up is a product that you purchased from a supplier and you want to keep track of the quantity and cost of those purchases, make sure you put a check mark here in this box. Enter the unit price, select the account, and the tax rate for the item as well. This information will help you to quickly populate purchase orders that you create and send to suppliers. Keep in mind that you can always change this on a per transaction basis. If you sell the item to a customer, you will need to enter the sales price information here. You will need to enter the unit price here, the sales account that you want to keep track of the income, the tax rate, and a brief description that you want to appear on quotes, estimates, invoices, and receipts for customers. Once you've completed all the fields, you want to make sure and save your changes. Once you save your changes, you should receive a notification here that shows you the new item has been added. While the steps to edit an inventory item are a piece of cake, there are some restrictions on what can and cannot be changed for both tracked and untracked inventory items. Let's discuss the limitations first, and then we will walk through how to make changes. For both tracked and untracked inventory items, if you change the item code, it will flow through to existing transactions, quotes, and purchase orders that use that inventory item. For both tracked and untracked inventory items, if you change any field other than the item code, it will only affect future transactions, quotes, and purchase orders that use that inventory item. You can convert an untracked item to a tracked item. Additional information on how this works can be found if you click the link below. For tracked inventory items, you cannot deselect the "I purchased this item" or "I sell this item" checkbox. And finally, a tracked item cannot be converted to an untracked item. Therefore, we suggest that you set up a brand new item if you need to untrack an existing inventory item. And let's go ahead and see how we would edit an inventory item. So we will go ahead and circle back to inventory by clicking accounts and then inventory. And then you just want to select the item that you'd like to change by clicking on it. To edit this item, we would simply need to just click the Edit Item button here. And any field that is not grayed out, you can make changes to. Once you have made all of the changes necessary, you can save your work. When it comes to deleting anything in an accounting software, the rule of thumb is generally that you should not do it. The primary reason for this is to ensure that historical information remains intact. Similar to editing, there are limitations on what inventory items can be deleted. Most of the limitations apply to tracked inventory because of the impact on cost of goods sold and the inventory value. Let's discuss the limitations first, and then we'll walk through the steps on how to delete an inventory item. You can't delete a tracked inventory item if it's been used on an approved invoice or an approved bill. One of the many features that makes Xero stand out ahead of its competitors is the ability to assign a role with specific permissions to a user. Depending on user permissions, you can set up employees who can only create transactions, and you or someone else must approve them. You will learn how user permissions work in the How to Invite Users lesson. Click this link to access this lesson. You can't delete a tracked inventory item if it's been used in a spend money or receive money transaction. A spend money or receive money transaction is when you pay for something, for example, spend, or receive money, for example, receive, like picking up lunch for the office or receiving a rewards check from your credit card company. You can't delete a tracked inventory item that you've added an opening balance to. And finally, you can't delete a tracked inventory item that you've made an adjustment to. You can't delete a tracked or untracked inventory item if it is used on a recurring invoice or bill. However, you can remove the item from the repeating recurring invoice or bill first, and then you can delete the item. Step-by-step instructions on how to do this can be found in the link below. To delete an inventory item, you simply want to select the item that you would like to delete. Click on the Options button here in the upper right-hand corner and select Delete. As you can see, we received a notification here that lets us know the impact of deleting an inventory item. And so in this case, it says deleting inventory items will not affect reports or historical transactions. And this is due to the fact that this item has not been used in a transaction. Please understand that once you click the delete button, there is no undo button. If you realize later on that you need an inventory item that you have deleted, you will have to add it back to your inventory item list. We recommend that you make an inventory item inactive before you delete it. If you have an inventory item that you no longer plan to use, but you cannot delete it because it has been used in a transaction, then you can make it inactive. You can mark tracked and untracked inventory items as inactive. To make an inventory item inactive, you want to go ahead and select that item, and then click the drop-down options button and select mark as inactive. It says the item has been updated. Items that have been marked as inactive will still display on your item list with inactive in the item name. And as you can see, that's what's taking place for this particular item that we just inactivated. It's still on the list with the inactive stamp to the right here. If you need to start using an inventory item that you previously marked as inactive, you can make this change pretty quickly. So we'll go ahead and select this item that is currently inactive, and you can click on the options button once again and select the mark as active option. It says the item has been updated. If we go back to our inventory list, now we see this item is listed here and the inactive mark or stamp has been removed. Another benefit of keeping track of your products and services in Xero is that you will have access to reports that will give you insight into your cost, quantities, and sale of all inventory items. To navigate to the inventory reports, we'll go to Reports and select All Reports. And on this screen, the reports are grouped by category, so we want the inventory grouping here. So you can see there's three reports listed here, but if we click on these dots, we've got a couple of more. So there are a total of 5 inventory reports listed here. 2 of the reports are older reports, and the reason why I say that is because they don't have the new stamp here like these 3 do. For the purposes of this lesson, we will focus on the 3 new reports. The new reports are part of Xero's recently updated reporting package that features greater customization. We'll discuss this in more detail in our Reporting in Xero course. Click this link to access this course. So let's first take a look at the Inventory Item Summary Report. The Inventory Item Summary Report shows all tracked, untracked, active, and inactive inventory items for a period of time. This report will show the opening balances, purchases, cost of goods sold, adjustments, closing balance, and sales for each item. The next report, Inventory Item Details Report. The Inventory Item Details Report shows the quantities on hand and changes to the value for all active inventory items. This report will not show any items that you have made inactive or that have been deleted. And finally, the Inventory Item List Report. The Inventory Item List Report shows the total quantity and value for all tracked and untracked inventory on hand. As you can see, this report shows you the item code, item name, the description of the items, the type, whether it's untracked or tracked, unit costs, unit sales price, the value of any inventory on hand, and the quantity on hand. That wraps up the lesson on how to set up products and services in Xero. To access our full Xero course or any of the other lessons in this series, click this link. You can also find a link below this video for a free 30-day trial of Xero. If you have feedback about this course or if you have any questions, please leave a comment below. Also, don't forget to subscribe.